Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to tackle a pretty common and sometimes confusing issue, the Windows Error Reporting Event ID 1001. If you have seen this error in your event viewer and you're wondering what it means and how to fix it, you're definitely in the right place. Don't worry, it sounds serious, but it's actually pretty easy to fix once you know the steps. Let's get started. First off, let's quickly talk about what this error even is. Event ID 1001 usually shows up when a program crashes or a system problem gets reported to Microsoft through Windows Error Reporting. It doesn't always mean something is broken permanently. Sometimes it's just a random glitch. But if you're seeing it often, especially linked to crashes, slowdowns, or freezes, then yeah, it's time to fix it. All right, the first thing you want to do is make sure Windows is fully updated. Updates often include important fixes for bugs and crashes. So check for updates, click the Start button, go to Settings, then Windows Update, and click Check for Updates. If there are any pending updates, go ahead and install them. After updating, restart your computer and see if the error still pops up. If you're still seeing the error, don't worry, we're just getting warmed up. Now let's check for corrupt system files. Sometimes corrupted files can trigger reporting errors. Here is how you do it. Open Command Prompt as administrator. Just search for CMD in your Start menu, right-click it, and choose Run as administrator. Now, in the command prompt, type this command sfc/scanout, then hit Enter. Windows will start scanning all your protected system files and will replace any corrupted ones with fresh copies. It might take a while. Just be patient and let it finish. Restart your computer and check if the error still shows up. If so, no problem. We have more tricks up our sleeve. Next step is running a DISM scan or the Deployment Imaging Service and Management Tool, which fixes Windows system images. In the same command prompt window, type the following commands one at a time and press Enter after each one. First one, type DISM/online/cleanup image/check health and press Enter. Next, type DISM/online/cleanup image/scan health. Then DISM/online/cleanup image/restore health. This process might take a little longer, especially the restore health part, but it's super important because it repairs the underlying system image that Windows uses. Once it's done, restart your computer again. Yeah, a lot of restarts today, but trust me, they really help. All right, now let's move on to another possible cause, problematic drivers. Sometimes outdated or corrupted drivers can cause programs to crash, leading to that event ID 1001. Open Device Manager by right-clicking the Start button and choosing it from the menu. Look for any devices with a yellow triangle or an exclamation mark. That's Windows' way of telling you something's wrong. If you see anything suspicious, right-click the device and choose Update Driver. Even if you don't see any warnings, it's a good idea to update your graphics card drivers, your network adapter, and any devices you recently installed. You can visit the manufacturer's website for the latest drivers or use Windows Update to grab the newest versions automatically. Still no luck? Don't worry. There is one more thing to try, which is checking the Reliability Monitor. This is a hidden little gem inside Windows that shows you a timeline of all the crashes, warnings, and updates. To open it, click Start and type Reliability Monitor, then click View Reliability History. Look for any recent critical events around the same time you notice the event ID 1001. Sometimes the Reliability Monitor will give you specific clues about which program or driver is causing the issue. If a particular app or program is listed again and again, try updating, repairing, or reinstalling it. And that's it. One of these methods should definitely help you fix the Windows Error Reporting Event ID 1001 for good. It can be a bit of trial and error sometimes, but don't give up. It's usually fixable with a little patience. If this guide helped you out today, please go ahead and hit that like button. And if you want more tech tutorials that actually make sense and walk you through step by step, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and tap the notification bell. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.